come from Russia, which means that Sanskrit is not my mother language. There are some issues to be solved, and I'm very thankful to the organizing committee for giving me a chance to speak about what is important for me. So when I started learning Sanskrit in 2002, I did not understand that there are no actually digital resources available, and slowly did I understand that if I do not do what I can do, then nobody will. And then I started to realize that the first thing I will need is a dictionary. My father said that when I was 5 years old, I played a game. It was called Trashman. So my father said, if you will play a lot of games, you will become Trashman. So higher education is needed not to be a Trashman. I got a PhD 5 years ago, and still I'm a Trashman. What do? I get out the dirt from the dictionary. Some people get good-looking jobs, and then there is a freshman. Nobody wants to be a freshman. Anyway, so I have heard repeating that the data set is an issue, and I believe that a list of clear head words at least is the first starting point. So if we make a spell checker, how do we know what words should be there? If we generate them from an output, are we sure that all the exclusions will be there? So the first thing I started was to try to understand how can I make a clear list of head words.
Historically, there have been, we have dictionaries starting from 1988. That was the first time. Dominik Kujawski said that it is about time to make something similar to Perseus. The main resource for Latin and Greek corpora, and make something similar. It was 1988. And at that point we said that many Sanskritists are highly computer literate. In 1988, so 30 years have passed, the literacy has been going down. That's what I see. I mean, that was a nice vision, but in fact, I mean, I really appreciate the idea of Professor Yu that says that we need to teach the teacher. I adore the idea. Because how can we require the students to use those tools if the teachers are unsure? So it's an amazing idea to teach the teachers. And at that stage, we had rifles 30 years ago. And the three things he was speaking about in his paper was Andrin Sankhi, a Sanskrit text archive, and a full textual reference that was meant like interlinking HTML documents. These three things were there for like 30 years ago. And now, a few of them have been solved actually. So Sankhi was solved, as I know, for the first time from the code which is available to me by Peter Sharp like in 1992. And after that, it was ported and updated by Jim Funderburg, who for me is like a godfather of the Colloquy Dictionary. He is the one and only person right now in the back end. There is Hava Patel from Gujarat helping, but the main workload is on Jim, who himself is actually a mathematician by background. So I do believe that the IT team last year, so the Pune Etymological Dictionary is still brand new. I mean, it's, they cannot use even the corpora, which is out there, regal, for example, because they are unical and Pune is regal. So you understand, it's like, it might sound like a small issue, but it becomes big if you don't know how to use it. So the OCR issue with Devanagari is solved once and forever, and the only question remains the size of the desk.
Yes, the blank.
So the three things that what I am looking right now. So Gretel was started in 2001, and the goal which Dominic saw at that time was simply
rapid access library. So he didn't mean the morphological analysis that Oliver did lately, or
what the stammer of Gerard can do. So no grammatical and lexical system. That was the initial idea in 1988, and by 2001 it was done. So it took like around 15 years to make it possible. But that's not what we are here for, right? We want to make it more advanced. So Oliver's visual corpus of sense, which started in 2010, has moved it forward. So it's not just a simply rapid access library. It has this level of detail we would want to. It has not the level of detail I would want that Peter Sharpe's code had in 2003. Still, it is like the golden standard of
nowadays. And then there is me, who is dreaming about a parallel corpora. And starting from 2013, I've been developing a Sanskrit-Russian, and there are some English and German, and I bet some French texts at one point there will be. So I want to have Rigveda, Atharveda, Mahabharata, and Ramayana in one place with a parallel text. Not just a simply rapid access library, but a parallel text. So we can teach the neural network or whatever, or a human being like me. I mean, if I want to find, if I want to make a new dictionary, I don't want to repeat the old ways that we were doing it in mid-19th century. I want to be corpora-based. But for corpora, I need a parallel corpora. So otherwise, I will do double work, which means it will be like a jail. Full contextual reference at Cologne Digital Dictionaries. I hope most of you have seen the site, Cologne Digital Dictionaries. The first time full contextual reference was done is was in 2018. It was not done. The initial plan Cardona had was to have it with Panini, but it was done with the Rig Veda in Grassmann's dictionary. I will show, I don't have time, how it looks. So we can add a new layer to the old dictionaries, a layer of hyperlinking to the real text. And that is why the Mahabharata project I'm interested in, because I want to hyperlink. I want the dictionaries to be 21st century and not mid-19th century. We are in the lexicography, we are still mid-19th century. And we will be there as long as we don't implement that corpora. At 1997, there was at the World Sanskrit Conference, Thomas Moulton, the very first person who started all those digitizations of dictionaries, he spoke about five things that have not yet been done by that point. So supplement, for example, Monier Blooms has a several page supplement that was not implemented. So the author himself wanted to change some things in the dictionary, and still they were not there in the digital copy corrected. So a digital copy is not one-to-one. We do fix errors that we are aware of. Transliteration of Greek was totally undone. 16 out of 33 dictionaries has Greek text in it. Not much, sometimes, still. So that means that the digitization was not fulfilled botanical terms. There are 8,000 botanical terms in, for example, Monia Williams. And they are not interlinked to a nowadays database because the plant names have changed in the 120 years that have passed since Monia Williams. Verbal forms. We have the data, but it's unstructured. So it's like a plain text going wide and deep and quite useless, I would say. Literary sources. So at that point, we did not knew what Monia Williams actually used as the editions. So not all of the editions we were aware of. So there are some abbreviations Monia Williams uses that we do not know how to encode still, about 11th. So, I mean, yeah, it's that was a time when the authors did not provide all the bibliographical details. That was the standard of that time. So in 2018, Jim said, it's fully integrated, as far as I know. And if he says it, it must be done. So, supplement is there, only 30 years after. Translation of Greek is done partly. Now we are doing proofreading of the Greek text that is typed in beta transliteration. So there is still a lot of work for about, let's say, 5 years. The botanical terms is an interesting point. I did start myself try to understand what's happening there. So there are about 15,000 cases where a botanical term is used in Monia Williams. And the markup you can see is used in a quite different way. So you see that in the synonym grain, it is not a single entity. It is like included in another one. That sometimes becomes a problem. So the Linnaean and taxonomy has changed over time. And there are quite many issues of miss markup. What do I mean? That the surnames of the scientists who have given the name was coded like a part of the plant name, which is actually not correct. We would want to know, for example, who is that hex. It's not a plant. Okay, so it was coded like in 1994, and there were other more critical issues, so this was not an issue at that time. Still, I would want some help from an Ayurvedic practitioner who could go through them and say, wow, this is impossible. So before that, we were thinking that L stands always for Carl Linnaeus in Monia Williams. But after that, I found out that it is not the usual way, it is lexicographer. L stands for lexicographer. When Monia Williams does not know what is the source, he gives lexicographer. But in case of plants, it's Linnaeus. And it's undocumented in the preface. So there are plenty of things undocumented, and the digitization helps us realize what is actually used in the book. There are quite some false positives, and for that we need human input. We, at some point, you do know that there are quite some verb form generators around, and authors of most of them are here in this room. So. At some point, we tried to systemize the data in Monia Williams to make it not just a list of plain words, but to interlink the verbal forms with a real generator so we can make use of it. And at that point, in 2017, what Jim did is he compared all the results of all the generators, not millions of forms, but hundreds of thousands forms, and it did show that there are quite many differences, but that's a topic for another discussion. Still, it's an interesting finding. So there is no easy way to interlink, because first we need to find out what source should we take for interlinking, because they are quite different. How Ampermanus and Girard's lists are differing in many ways. The literary sources. As for today, it's only for Rig Veda, because there is no problem with numbering, and that's the only reason. It is easy to do, and that's what it's done. For example, there are issues like punctuation between literary sources. It breaks up sometimes some sources in several sub-pseudo sources. So issues are there. We have not yet finished even the review of the abbreviations. So, I mean, we are still at the basics level. We cannot grasp the sky saying, oh, many moons long ago, let's start ignore. First, we need to understand what has been done. I do not know what he has done and what he has meant. I only partly sometimes understand. So, by cleaning up the dirt, you get useful byproducts. So in 2016 at Bangkok, the Havel had a presentation about unification of handwords. So that was the very start of the cleanup of handwords. So before cleaning up the entries in the dictionaries, I said I insist on having a list of clear words in the handwords. So what do we have? There are different standards writing the same word. There are different standards writing the same word. You do not know in advance which author uses which method. So a computer can unify it, and we have done it, and there are all those URLs are there available. You can check yourself. So there is a list of 380,000 unique words in Sanskrit by cleaning out all the duplicate entries in 33 Sanskrit dictionaries. We have made it look like in the original book. So we did some CSS fonts. And there is a cleanup going on actually every year. We have converted it to IST. That means there is no ST anymore. Copy-friendly ST. Okay, the XML markup was totally different for each dictionary. You know that feeling when you start to code and forget what you did yesterday? And you start it all over, and then if it's 30 years, then at one point, it is like a big mess. So, for the code to be reusable, it has to be clean. And that's not obvious, actually. And it's actually simple search is what Girard calls Sanskrit made easy. You can type with spelling errors now at Colloquium. This is the major feature I want you to remember. If there is one thing you should remember out of my speech, that is simple search at Colloquium. So I can type Ranasi without the prefix and still get the word. The algorithm is not as simple as Girard's. I would want to document and show it to you. I would want it to be as a model you can reuse or improve. Cartago de Lenda est. What I say is, we need a clean data set, and I'm ready to go to this jail. But I need help, because 2.5 people have done in 5 years that I know. What if we unite and 25 people would start to clean up the dirt? That I do not know where we will end, but I propose we start. So this is the URL of the GitHub repository where are all those sources for dictionaries, all those byproducts, so we can make a spell checker. Actually, we have made one, a Sanskrit, MS Word, whatever, spell checker, a browser spell checker, a Hunt spell checker, whatever. Some practical things, like a hyphenator. Do you have a Sanskrit hyphenator? Do you print Sanskrit books? Have you seen what's going on with the Samasa? Wow, it's bad, it looks bad. And having a clean, heavier list, we can make a hyphenator for Adobe InDesign. So I propose Sanskrit dataset crowdsourcing. I love the idea of Martin. I love the idea I heard yesterday. I don't believe a one person can do it. I don't believe a team can do it. Only crowdsourcing. If 1,000 people cannot do it, 10,000 can. Why not? If my time is out, I will not show you nothing else than to say thank you for your patience.
So thanks a lot for the talk. Time for one or two questions. Right, so I was just curious that what kind of, just one quick question, that what kind of Sanskrit enthusiast do you want? What is the aspect or what is
the level? He must have hands, eyes. If brain is attached, that would be a bonus. It's enough. I mean, I do a lot of monkey work myself.
So let me actually rephrase my question. Why can't you do it using AMP? Or a medical list and ask amateurs especially.
I have asked a BVP once per year for the last 10 years, so anyway, I'm here to try to unite some of our efforts. Because I really feel bad when I see that, oh, I have spent 5 years on this and this guy has made it better than I did. I would better have some sleep at that time. So anyway, the mailing list idea is good, but somehow it doesn't work always. That's why I had to came in person. And I say, doctor said crowdsourcing is the key of making a change. You are very good at describing rules. You are very good at making yet another Sankey analyzer. The rules are good, fine-tuned. 30 years of fine-tuning. But the data set is not there. In almost every paper I had the word, data set, not full, data set, there, not there. I want to change it. I can change it. Alone, impossible. My wife will kill me before I get halfway done. My children will not see me. Can we unite? Should we be like India is separate, no idea what's in Europe, Europe has not the slightest idea what's in India? For how long? 30 years they have been waiting.
So I think in the interest of time, we will go ahead with the closing remarks, because some people have to leave.